much similarity does the FBI as an organization have to the mob?
You're trying to set me up, so I'll be careful here. The old, what I call the old mob, the real true Italian LCN mob, where there was structure and hierarchies, it's a chain of command, just like the FBI or the US military. There is a chain of command, all right? And you have to understand your position and what you have to do. Now, I'm making no association that the FBI is like the mob, other than in structure, chain of command, reporting up the chain. So that would be the only similarity between the two that I would say is prevalent in comparing the two.
I had a John A. Light here. He was a former Albanian associate of the Gotti family, and he said what made the mob work is fear and structure. Because there was the fear, if you cross the line and you don't do it, the highest level of fear is what? You know, you're going to get killed. Right. And then structure with the whole levels and hierarchy and, right, you know, rituals and all that other stuff. Was that pretty normal with all the three families that you were working undercover?
Yes, very. You knew who reported to who. And that was the key. And that's just like in the FBI. You're not going to get killed in the FBI if you don't do your job, but you're gonna lose your position. Something's gonna happen. There's consequences to your actions, and that's why the mob was easier to investigate, because somebody couldn't go wild off the reservation. If they decided they were gonna do something serious, they had to go up 3-4 levels to get the okay, and that's what we appreciate. And so we focused our attention, obviously, on the decision makers. Those are the Guglielmetti's, the Merlinos, the D'Annunzios. We want to get into that decision-making executive level of the crime families, because we're dealing with the people who are deciding at the end what's going to be done.
Was there anything you saw that was honorable that they did?
The only thing, I tell people I felt bad about one thing, and all the time I did that, in the Providence case, the Patriarca family case, Matty Guglielmetti's dad died during the investigation. His father was a mobster, and Matty took over for his dad, but his father, elderly, and he passed away. And I went to the services, as I was expected to do, and at the service, I was told that I needed to go into the family crypt where they were burying their father. And I was brought into the family burial site with basically the immediate family, and I had a tape recorder running. And I didn't really feel very good that day. That was not a day to collect evidence. That was a family that was legitimately grieving. So I did feel, you know, I did feel some remorse for doing it. I didn't have a choice. Obviously, I can't stop and take the recorder off.
Were you upset with yourself that you felt remorse, or no?
No, because I think that's human nature. When somebody's family member dies, I'd like to think, you know, yeah, are they mobsters? Yes, but they also have family. And I understand some of these guys are very, very good family members. But again, they choose their path, and you know, we react accordingly. If somebody's not in the business, we're not going to go out and find them. There's a reason somebody's name comes to the attention of the FBI, and it's usually because they're up to no good.